Battle Royale games like PUBG has been attracting a lot of video game lovers all over the world. These kind of games involve a lot of violence, which is why a lot of parents are concerned worldwide. And not only that, many partners are complaining about it as well. These games has been common thread in many violent crimes in recent time, making all of us wonder whether this game itself has something to do with this rising trend. Today, I have a question from someone who wants to know if games like PUBG can make someone behave violent or aggressive. So let's discuss more on this. There are a lot of narratives being built that these games are causing addiction among users. And in a state of game-induced euphoria, some individuals have resorted to violent actions. In one such case, a youth had killed his family in a fit of rage, was linked to PUBG. And in another case, this gamer was so influenced that he started hitting himself and ended up in hospital. Before I talk about what could be the reason behind all these violent behavior, you should know that scientists from Oxford University conducted a very robust experiment to find link between aggression and violent video games. In February 2019, they published their result in which they found no correlation between violent video games and increased aggression in the players. We often attribute criminal behaviors to one incident that might have triggered the crime, but we fail to understand root cause of any addiction, and violent behavior is not online games or any foreign substance. It is solely because of the untreated mental illness that manifests itself in disturbing reactions in ordinary real life situations. We need to understand that gamer may be suffering from hopelessness, loneliness, anxiety, depression, or maybe some other form of psychological issues. And these often manifest in the form of antisocial behavior and aloofness from society. Something as abstract as violent content and aggression is hard to study. Violent content is everywhere. It's in our news, sports, movies, novels, TV series, and in our history. It is hard to study because it is all over there in our timeline. So remember, violent behavior occurs only when multiple risk factors are present. And no single risk factor is the cause of violent act. Sometimes gaming overuse can be a symptom that something is going wrong for the gamer. And possibilities are, problem is bigger than gaming and gaming didn't cause it. Games like these help people to kill their time which they should be taking out for their hobbies. It is fine to play these games, but in a limit. Overdoing it is becoming a major problem for everyone. So if you are one of those who is addicted of this game but want to get out of it, here are few tips to avoid playing this game for you. First is, dedicate a particular time for this game from your entire day schedule. Make sure that you play this game only in the dedicated time period and try to keep that timing after your hectic work so that you calm your head after playing this game for some time. Second is, avoid replaying this game once you have failed to win. Most of the time, people try to play that game again if they lost the previous match. So it is important for you to know that you have to stop after a certain time. Third is, do not watch online gaming videos. It is often seen that people surf videos online in YouTube and in other places and then they switch over to start playing it. It is recommended that you do not watch such videos, which will help you to prevent playing it as well. Fourth is, do not come in others' influence to play the game. Those who are already playing this game often ask their friends to join their team and you should always avoid such calling. Fifth is, engage yourself in doing something which makes you feel happy. If you're fond of playing instruments, keep yourself engaged in playing instruments rather than playing games. If you feel you or someone you know is having behavioral issue because of video gaming, then please go and consult a professional for this. There are many treatments available for these kind of problems, but you just have to reach out to a professional for this.
Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to give this video a like and subscribe. We will meet next week with a new video on mental health, so stay tuned. Till then, wish you a healthy mind and a happy life. Bye-bye.